Question 3. The difference between the two number is 26. The one number is 3 times the other number. Find them. Is it? Other number be y. So one number will be 3 times. Is it? What is given is that one number is 3 times the other. Is it? So one number will be 3y. Let other number be y. Then the one number will be 3 times other, means 3y. So according to the condition of problem, what is one more equation is given, that difference between the two number is 26. So x minus y is 26. Is it? So what is x? Let us substitute x as 3y. Is it? This will be taking as x. So x minus y is 26. Substitute the value of x. X is equal to 3y. So 3y minus y is equal to 26. So y is equal to 13. Substituting the value of y in equation 1, which is this, you'll get x is equal to 39. Thus the number are 39 and 13. Radius of two supplementary angle exceed the small by 18. Suppose the largest of the supplementary angle is x, the other, the smaller number will be x plus 18. X plus 18, is it? Find them. Let the smaller number be x. So larger degree will be, the larger angle will be, okay, let the smaller angle be x, then the larger angle will be y is equal to x plus 18. So according to a condition of problem, what is given, that supplementary angle, no, it is supplementary, two supplementary angle, so implies x plus y is equal to 180. Okay, substitute y is equal to what? X plus 18. Here if you substitute, then x plus x is equal to 18 is equal to 180. So 2x is equal to 180 minus 18. So 2x is equal to 162. X is equal to 81. Substituting the y in that, this, so you'll get y is equal to 99. Thus the smaller number or smaller angle, this is smaller angle, smaller angle is 81, and the larger angle, not number, it is angle, and the larger angle is 99. The coach of a cricket team buy 7 bat and 6 ball for ₹3,800. Later C buy 3 bat and 5 ball for ₹1,750. Find the cost of each ball. Of balls, or let the bat, number of bats will be x and number of ball will y. So according to condition of problem, first, what is that, 7 bats, so 7x plus 6y is equal to 3800. And later, what is it, 3 bat and 5 ball, 3x plus 5y is equal to 1700. Okay, elimination method we can do, we can make y equal, by coefficient of y equal. So if you multiply this with 5, then 30. If you multiply with this 6, then it will become 30, and we can eliminate that. Is it? So multiply first equation by 5, second equation by 6. Is it? If you substitute that, okay, if you substitute and then cancel it out, you will get x is equal to 500. So the cost of bat is 500, and if you substitute, then you'll get y is equal to 250 or 50. So cost of ball is rupees 250. One more method is there. Suppose you do it, x plus 6y is equal to 300. You do like this, 3800. Next is 3x plus 5y is equal to what? 1750. Add it. So what will become? 10x and 11y is equal to, a you add it, 0, 5, then it 15 to 5, carry 1, 4, 5. Is it? This will be one equation, and then subtract this and then solve it. You can do like this also. Okay. C Subtract this and get the answer. Then you solve first and second equation. Taxi charges in the city consist of a fixed charge together with the charge for the distance covered. For a distance of 10 km, the charge paid is ₹105. And for a journey of 15 km, the charge paid is ₹155. What are the fixed charges per kilometer? How much does a person have to pay for traveling a distance of 25 km? Got it? So let the fixed charge be X and the charges for a distance kilometer per kilometer is rupees Y. So for a distance of 10 kilometers, is it here? The fixed charges be X and the charges for the distance covered be Y. So according to condition of problem, how much distance is covered? 10 kilometers. So fixed charges is X plus 10Y per kilometer is Y. The distance charges per kilometer is Y. Then it will be X plus 10Y is equal to 105. Second, for 15 kilometer, so X plus 15Y is equal to 155 CP. So if you solve this with the elimination method, Y is equal to 10 and X is equal to 5. So the fixed charges, thus the fixed charges is rupees 5 and charges per kilometer is rupees 10. How much one has to pay? So you'll get equation as, is it? For 15 kilometer, how much one has to pay? Is it? So it is 5 plus 10y is equal to how much you have to pay, is it? So that will be equal to 5 plus 10 into 15 kilometer. So 10, it is 150 plus 5. So he has to pay rupees 155. Okay. For 15 kilometer. No, for 25 kilometer we asked. So it will be 5 plus 10 into 25 will be equal to, this is 5 plus, or we can write 10y plus 5. Is it? So this will come here as it is 10 into 25 plus 5. So it is 250 plus 5. So it will be rupees 255. Fraction become 9 by 5 if 2 is added to both numerator and the denominator. Is it? If 3 is added to both numerator and denominator, the fraction become 5 by 6. Find the fraction. The numerator be X and the denominator be Y. So the fraction become X upon Y. According to condition of problem, is it? If 2 is added to both numerator and denominator, so numerator will become X plus 2, denominator will become Y plus 2, and the fraction is given as 9 by 11. If you solve this, cross multiply it. If you solve this equation, you'll get 9y minus 11x minus 4 is equal to 0. According to condition of problem, if you add 3 to numerator as well as the denominator, so x plus 3 upon y plus 3 is equal to 5 by 6. If you cross multiply it, you'll get 6x minus 5y plus 3 is equal to 0. If you solve this first and second by elimination method, you'll get x is equal to 7. Substituting this value in equation or any one of the equation or equation first here, you will get y is equal to 9. So fraction become 7 by 9. Okay, x upon y. X is 7, y is 9, so x 7 upon 9. So thus the fraction is 7 upon 9. 5 years hence, the age of Jacob will be 3 times the of his son. Age of Jacob will be 3 times of his son. You got it clear? 5 years ago, Jacob was 7 times that of his son. What are their percentage? Percentage of Jacob be X years and his sons will be Y years. 5 years later means after 5 years. The age of Jacob would be X plus 5 years and the age of son will be Y plus 5 years. At that time, father is what? At that time, what is given to us is that will be 3 times of his son. His father will be 3 times of his son. So x plus 5 is equal to 3 in the bracket of his son y plus 3. Y plus 5. Is it? So this is father, Jack of his father. So his age is 3 times of his son. So what is his age now? X plus 5. So X plus 5 is equal to 3 times of his son. 3 into his son. Son age is what? Y plus 5. So if you simplify it, you get X minus 3y minus 10 is equal to 0. 5 years ago, ago means before, the age of Jacob will be, was, the age of Jacob was, okay, and here also will come as was. The age of Jacob was X minus 5 years, and the age of son was Y minus 5 years. Okay, that time Jacob was 7 years more than his sons. So X minus 5 is equal to 7, Y minus 5 is son. If you simplify it, you'll get X minus 5, X minus 7Y, X minus 7Y plus 30 is equal to 0. From first and second, if you solve it, you'll get by elimination method, multiply with 7, multiply with 3, you'll get X is equal to 40. Value of, subtracting the value of X in the equation 1, you'll get Y is equal to 10. So the age of, thus the age of Jacob is 40 years, and age of his son is 10 years.